going on, guys? Yamaha 6 here, and I'm doing a tutorial of how to change the sprockets. This is going to work for 06, 07, 08, and 09, because this is a 2009 R6, and the setup is the exact same as my bike. So, and my bike's an 07, so everything's going to go as planned as it did last time. We're using the same exact sprockets as my bike. You're going to need something to cut off the chain. We just got these big-ass bolt cutters. We're going to have, what the fuck is this called? The breaker bar, because you don't want to use the torque wrench, because you can break the torque wrench. And then just grease for the wheel and other shit like this for taking off small stuff. And then just a pile of shit in here. So, also you're going to need a stand and spools. You do need spools, especially for my stand. I know you can get the stand that will just go on the swing arm, but I don't have that. And then shit to clean up. So let's go ahead and get started here. Alright, so it is kind of a pain in the ass to get everything off, but you gotta take off this guy right here. Screw down there, there's a screw over there, there's a screw on the bottom here, another one right there. Then there is a pop clip right there. I don't know if you guys can see that. That's a little push clips. Another push clip right here. Just got pulled out and it all goes into the fairing accordingly. What else we got? I think that's about it. Blinker. After you take all those out, and then you don't have to worry about on the 2008-2009, you can just take off this whole piece as one. On my bike, you can't take this whole piece as one. You have to take them off individually, but we're just going to take this whole piece. So right now, we're going to have to take the blinker off just to get it disconnected from the bike, and then we'll start the video back up of changing everything out. So all right, guys, give me a second. All right, so got the blinker disconnected, and now the bike is half naked. Yeah, so basically now we're going to take off this cover. And then take off that cover, you're going to take off that bolt. Some people like to remove the whole shifter. I don't like to do that, so we're just going to take off. It just takes off this whole lever and makes it dangle. I usually lock it up somewhere over here or something like that. But we're going to take off this bolt right here. This bolt is in the fairing, so it's not there anymore. Either that or this bike just doesn't have that one. There's a little guy heading right there, right there. Right there. After you take off this, you're going to see the front sprocket. And this is the same on an 07, 06, 08, 09. And I'm not sure about the 10s and 11s, but I know for sure 4 years, this is the exactly same. So let's go ahead and take this off, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like. All right, so once you have the three little bolts taken off, you're going to look at this hideous, amazing-looking sprocket here. This thing will just come right off. Literally, there's nothing else to it. You probably have about 3,000 dead bugs and other lovely creatures up in there. And also, this color of this guard is supposed to be black, but it's like shit brown. So that means you might want to clean it. This thing also lifts right out of here. Now, if you lick that, I will give you $5.
It's not happening.
So that's basically how that goes. The more grime that's put up under here, guys, the more contact it's going to come with the chain, and the more shit it's going to get on the chain. As you see, this is a brand new lovely chain. This looks like if you poke it, the shit will fall off. We're changing everything, so yeah, guys, now you're going to take this guy off, which a lot of people say can't be done and it's hard as shit, but honestly, on my bike, I had no problems doing it, and it was really easy. So we're going to go ahead and take that off now, and we're going to show how that's done. So give me a second, guys. As I said before, there's little creatures living inside of his oh my god, it's a fucking web in there. See yeah. People, this is why you need to clean your shit, because then you'll get scary little creatures. Yeah. All right, now that we have this on here, breaker bar, try not to use the torque wrench, you can ruin it. And breaker bar gives you a lot more leverage, as you see, and you can just take this baby off. This is a 32 millimeter. I don't know, you guys can see it. So, 32 millimeter, and I'm gonna have Thomas hold the camera here while I break this sucker off. I'm gonna put lots of leverage on it. And see, people, everyone says it's really hard, but really, it's not hard at all. We have leverage, it does not take any time at all. Yeah, it's hand tight. We just wanna get it hand tight right now, because we still gotta take off the back sprocket. So, we're gonna go ahead and, show you guys how to take off the back wheel while I catch my breath, but that's how that looks with it almost all the way off. So, all right, now we're gonna cut off someone's balls. Your turn, Thomas.
Funny.
Put it down here. All right, so I got these from Home Depot, Lowe's, wherever. They work anywhere. So, Thomas, grab it. You're going to want to use a tip. Thomas told me that last time I was sitting here trying to fucking take it off. You want to go right in between the links and...
And just... Did it break?
I don't think so. And you're just going to squeeze like that.
It's not even grabbing. It's breaking the chain.
Let's try this again.
There we go.
Alright. Break one side and just put it over to the other side. Obviously, if you want to keep your chain, some people do it and keep their chain as a spare. You're going to want to find the master link. But the only thing this chain is going to be able to do is house spiders. So after you cut that baby off, it will fall like so, and we'll feed it through here if it even moves. We gotta put it in neutral or not in neutral.
Grab the clutch.
Go ahead. Yeah, I just shifted with my hand. You're gonna pull it out, and it's gonna look like that, like a lunk of nothing.
Look at that thing.
So, yeah. All right, guys. So now we're going to remove.
Look at the other side.
We're gonna remove the wheel now, so let's go ahead and do it. All right, guys, so to take off this, I think the front was actually a 30. The back is a 32. Again, we're using the breaker bar, and just gonna push down on it. It should come right off like so. And unfortunately, you have to keep taking it off and putting it back on, so. The rear axle's a little easier to get off, because it's a little more exposed, so it doesn't get quite as hidden and rust tight.
No.
I don't think yet. It's still kind of. There it is. All right, so I twist this baby off. One tip I can give you guys about not losing washers and stuff: when you take stuff off, put it how you took it off, like just like that, and have it facing down or up like that. And basically, check all around here just to make sure there's no extra washers, because while you're taking stuff off and everything falls, you're not going to know where everything went. So just make sure you do that. So now we're going to hit the axle to the other side. A mallet wrench would be perfect to do, but unfortunately we don't have that. So now, while we do this, the other two personas that are here are going to hold the wheel so the wheel doesn't come down. So you have one person hold it like that, and the other person to answer their phone because they're not doing anything else. So he's going to pull it out, and then he can just let the wheel just go down to the ground. And just like that. So I'm thinking that's because there was no grease on this, but that axle came out pretty easy. But that's really it, guys, for taking off the axle. Nothing fell. There is spacers in here and on the other side, so right, make sure the spacers don't fall and whatnot. So, here it is right here. This is a spacer. Make sure that doesn't fall, and then refeel on the other side to make sure nothing else is falling or anything. So, all right, guys, we're going to go ahead and take off this sprocket. All right, so taking off the rear sprocket bolts, it's a 17 millimeter thingamajigger. You're just going to take them off like so, set them off to where you can find them. Have someone hold down the wheel. You don't want the brake caliper hitting the ground, because you'll scratch it and fuck it up and whatnot. Each one of these has a washer. So again, guys, watch for washers. You do not want to lose those guys like that. We're going to do it just like that. Every time you take one off, take the washer and the bolt off, set it off to the side. So we're going to do this for all these, and then we're going to put the new sprocket on, and we're going to put it down to torque. So let's go ahead and fast forward through this real quick. All right, guys, sprocket lifts it up like that, and then we're gonna put the new fancy one on like so. That look nice. I love this sprocket. All right, so you're not just gonna put these suckers on here and be like, okay, hand tight and good. Put washers on whatnot first. Then when you do that, you're gonna have to get the torque specs, which I'm gonna bring up the torque specs right now, so give me a second. All right, guys, so torque wrench, This is a half drive, I think. Half drive just tells you, like, I didn't know this until my friend says. Half drive just shows how big this is. I just have an adapter piece. It goes on here, but this doesn't need one for, like, the fourth drives and stuff like that. But, anyways, you're going to put it on there just like a regular socket wrench, and you're going to tighten it to 25 increments. You don't want to just keep putting, you don't want to put every single one down to, see, it'll click when it's done. Put them all down to 25, and then 50, and then 72. This one is supposed to take 72 on the rear sprocket. So you're going to put them all down to 25. So, I don't know if you guys can hear the clicking, but it clicks. You feel it when you're using the torque, when you're using it. Like that.
You get to the pressure.
Alright, and I think this is the last one.
You're going opposite.
Yeah, I'll do that. Alright, so what Thomas just said was a good point. When you're doing stuff like this, you should go across kind of like that, like this one, that one to that one, that one to that one, just so everything is tightened down evenly. That was only 25 pounds, so it shouldn't hurt it too bad, or shouldn't hurt it at all at least. Alright, so now we're going to put the torque wrench up to 50. Alright, now we're going to do the same thing. So we're going to start on this side. Might have to have someone hold it now because it does get a little tough.
Like we did last time.
Here. Alright, so we're going to go get those. We're going to go to here. 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 And here. Alright, so everything's at 50, so now we're going to...
Did you get this one?
Yeah, I got one. That was the first one I did. So now I'm going to go down to 72 foot-pounds. Tighten this torque. Just go right here. Go across. Right here. Go across. And go across. Alright, so just make sure it doesn't fall out its cush drive, because that can fall out. It just helps it so it doesn't mess up that. So that's a rear sprocket, guys, on the wheel. So now we're going to, I think we're going to go ahead and put the wheel back on and then change out the sprockets. Yeah, the front sprocket. So let's go ahead and get to that one. Alright, now we're going to take this off. It has little grooves and stuff. That's why you have to buy one to fit your bike. This is really heavy compared to this guy. You can just see the thickness. And this has like lightning holes to make it go quicker. This thing is heavy as shit. It's also 16 teeth. You can see right there. This is a 15 tooth. I've always been told to keep the lettering outwards. It really doesn't matter, I don't think. But on this one it does, because it has that groove. So you're going to just put this guy on there and just fit the grooves on there. And it will just go on just like that. So now we're going to put this guy back on, and then we're going to put the washer, and then we're going to get the torque screwdriver, torque, whatever the fuck it's called, and torque it down. So give us a second here, guys.
All right,
guys, now we're going to put the wheel back on. I said we were going to tighten this down, but you can't tighten it down. You can if you put it in gear, and that's the brake's not on, so you can't push down the brake. If you put this in gear and tighten this to spec, you can really hurt the gearbox and really, really hurt the bike. So what are you going to do?
Yeah.
So you're gonna line it up. Take you guys over here.
Fucking.
It is a bitch. You have to line up the brake caliper and the brakes on there, and then you have to line up the wheel. So
the brakes. Go ahead. Like clamp.
Okay, we'll loosen it. All right, guys, give us 1 second. You want to just space out the brakes if they get pushed together. All right, now try to fit it on there. Tight. All right, guys, give us 1 second. All right, guys, after we finally got the brake caliper on, it is a true bitch to get on. You're gonna get grease, axle grease, whatever. This is just wheel bearing, chassis, suspension, joint grease.
It takes heavy loads.
Yeah, it accepts heavy loads under extreme heat and pressure. So you're just gonna do what Thomas is doing here. Get a little bit, and it's kind of nasty, so.
This is where it turns into porno material.
Oh yeah,
right there.
Get it.
All right, so you see Thomas is a professional handling
poles. Oh, yeah, always. Got one of my own, so I know how to work it. Not on other dudes, but yeah. you know what I mean. Don't take that the wrong way.
All right, after it's lubed up, looks like you killed a baby. He's going to stick it in the hole, which is not too well.
I'm pro at that.
All right, you have to line up, get it through there, Thomas.
Come towards the front.
Right there. It will go through, Thomas.
It is not moving. I think I got it in on this side, but I think it's like crooked.
Not there. There it is.
And right. Line up.
Hit it one more. Wait. Pull up on the wheel. One more time. There it is.
Hold on.
And there she blows.
I can't go through.
All right.
What am I hitting?
Give me a second. All right, guys, now we're going to bang it through the other side, so you get the point. Just hitting it right there. So. All right, so after you hit it through, the last part you're going to have to hit through with something soft, like that. Duralast. you have to line up the straight part with that straight part, and it will come across through the brake caliper. All the way over here like this. You're going to take the washer. And
I wouldn't even want to do that. You get your handlebars all greasy.
And you're just going to put it on there the right way. And like me. Retard trying to put on something. And what you're going to do is feed the front of the chain through, just put your hands in here and stuff like that, come all across to the front sprocket, and then we have it sitting down right here right now. It's sitting up on here. If I was to try to pull these together, they will not fit. You have to use the chain adjusters on both sides to move the wheel up or farther, like you'll move it up to get it on, and then tighten it, you'll move it farther away. These are the chain adjusters on my bike too. They're on both sides. You have to use both sides evenly. And then you're going to use these lines and make sure the wheel is aligned correctly, because if it's not aligned on both sides, then you're going to be riding with a crooked wheel, which in the long run will not end very well for you. So let's go ahead and try to fit this together real quick. All right, guys, so it's a bitch to get the links together, but once you actually get them together, we just put the master link through. And you're actually going to have to use a vice grip to pull. You're
going
to have to pull this through. And like after you pull with the vice grips, this plate is gonna pop through just like all these will, and it will be in place. And that's where you put your C clip in. So he's gonna go ahead and try to pull.
Hold on, I gotta.
A little too loose.
Hey, I'm just.
You'll find the right. Yeah, you'll find the right, and then right when you pull, you. As you see, it's kind of popping through now.
It will.
Okay. So. Now that you have pushed it through with these things, it does take some muscle. You'll see there's a gap. That's where you're going to fit the C-clamp into. Basically, you're going to put it like that. And then you're going to use needle-nose pliers to push this side. And to use one of these as a pushing thing until that goes over that. And that goes into there. So we're going to go ahead and do that. Try to keep the camera on. It does get a little tricky. So.
Good. I can't get leverage on it.
Why not?
Let me get where you're sitting.
No, I want to sit here. I'm just kidding.
What's a dickhead saying?
All right, so let's move around. We're gonna try to hold this for.
Oh shit,
Mr. Thomas here.
Hey,
hey. Getting Thomas's way so you can't see what he's doing. And
hold on.
Oh, you almost had it, Thomas.
I gotta loosen him up a little bit. I couldn't get him to click.
One, two.
Oh!
So close.
That's what she
said.
Don't
pinch my fingers.
I'm trying not to.
You get a yummy
fucking fat sausage fingers out of your way.
Hey, look, fucker. And.
Oh, it's so close.
Yay! Woo. And you have the C-clamp on there. And just make sure all the joints are good, and they are. And now, it has a little too much slack, so we're going to go ahead and tighten it, align it, and we're going to put everything back on, tighten this sucker back down, and be good to go, guys. So give us 1 second here. All right, guys, so now we're going to tighten the front sprocket back down. Thomas is pushing the back brake. We're in neutral. And then we're going to get this down to 62 foot-pounds, and then we're going to tighten up the chain, and we'll be good to go. So let's go ahead and do this. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end the camera here, and then we'll have it when we're tightening the chain. All right, guys, you're going to want to have it aligned, so we're going to have this first mark almost on the swing arm. If you look right here, the first mark is almost on the swing arm here. To chain adjust, you're going to use these Allen wrench things right here. They're on both sides. Move your hand, you gay fish.
I'm trying to tighten it.
And just like that. And then you're going to tighten the nut to make sure they don't move at all when you're doing this. All right, guys, so I hope you enjoyed my little yummy how-to. Front sprocket, everything is on. Thomas is just finalizing, tightening up some stuff to make sure everything's good. Loctite is nice to have. A lot of these already had some Loctite on it, so if you can see in here. We're going to go ahead and put everything back on how it was, and chain slack's about an inch. It's just exactly where you want it, so about an inch to an inch and a half of play is usually how you want it to be. So. Yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this. His bike looks a lot better now. Looks like he can actually ride it. So he just got it, and it's not his. The thingy's looking moved a little bit.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, you can readjust it. You don't have to lube it yet. You can if you want, but if you really look in there, there's a shit ton of lube on this chain. This is a 520 conversion kit for this bike. It's down one in the front, two up in the back. But yeah, guys, it went pretty well. It went a lot faster than I did my bike because we actually knew what we were doing this time. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, send me a message on Facebook or on YouTube, either or works. I'll get to them as I can. I do have a lot of stuff going on. So if you guys have any questions for anything as far as the C-clip, how to put the chain, sprockets, torque specs, hit me up and I will have no problem helping everyone. I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. And if you guys want to see anything else, let me know. And also submit topics for later motovlogs. All right, guys, everyone take it easy and enjoy the rest of your weekend.